So the game had a lot of updates and most of them were really, really cool. But now we'll just have to play from the beginning on the hardest difficulty. If you play on Dangerous World, well, this is nothing like Rimworld. In Rimworld, you have a chance. If you play on Dangerous World, in this game, you don't really have a chance. So it's basically like, it's not like Rimworld. It's much more complex and much more hard to control everything. So you'll see what I mean. So first of all, we need a doctor and a miner who can mine iron. Well, damn. Unfortunately, you have to avoid that trait because he can't gain any experience. So your first colonist, meaning the two, have to be very, very good. Or if you play on a lower difficulty, it doesn't really matter because you can remove their bad traits. Okay, wow, this guy is very good. But as you can see, he has some problems. Now, I won't go too crazy with this because I want to start the game today and not tomorrow. So miner, mining iron, and also a good farmer. Well, that's actually exactly what I needed. And now I need a doctor, but the doctor has to be able to apply splints, otherwise your people will just get a lot of penalties, because injuries can occur all the time. Master outfit. So their outfits will also give them a small bonus, so let's just... Oh, man, this guy is really stacked. I wish I could take him, but no, we can't do it. Now, the reason I'm taking a farmer, which is a miner, is because you don't always need to be... You don't always need to mine all the time. And basically, some other founders can do that. I almost want to call them dwarfs. So, this guy is pretty good, I have to say, but I'm looking for something a little better. So the big problem with the game is that in the beginning you will have to... He's good at swords. So I guess a doctor who can kill stuff is better. Okay, we'll just take it like this. So Bernard... Actually, normally I would take a doctor who can study, because that's kind of like the thing you want to do in the beginning, but it's okay. Pessimist. Well, they have a permanent bad mood, but that's okay. They're just like me sometimes. So let's enjoy the game for what it is, and because it's going to be a very, very rough trip, you'll see what I mean soon enough. So the first thing you need to do is find a good base location. Now you also have animals. Those are cows. Hello, little cow. Oh, look at... They also have names, August the cow. Now, on a hard map like this, on the Dangerous World, you'll find usually 4 or 5 goblin villages, and they all have their different... Diplomacy screen, meaning you can trade with them if you run out of food, and you can also do a lot of stuff with the villagers, so don't consider them all enemies, and some of them are much bigger as this one. So we have 2 villages over here, smaller ones. Only a 2-hut village, well, that's nice. And we should have another big one somewhere around the other side of the map. Oh. That's actually pretty good, because they, I think they'll be on the same side of the map. So this should mean that... Oh, it's not clear. There is one over here, a little camp. But we have a lot of trees, apple trees here, which is amazing. We don't seem to have a lot of crystals, so the main base will be somewhere around here, because this is where most of the resources are located. But it'll be very close to the bigger goblin village. Not ideal, I have to say. So let's look for another location. We basically want the apple trees, the crystals, and the stone and iron ore. Nope. Not going to get a better location. Well... Actually, let's risk it. Why not? Yeah. Also, don't pick anyone with limping, because that will kind of destroy your early game. These are our resources. Some of them have multiple types. So textiles is cotton, wool, and cloth. Now, I'll actually be making a base somewhere over here. And we'll actually spread over there. And let's speed up the game while they are coming here.
Yep.
Okay, so both of them will actually have to be foresters. And they have to cut a lot of trees down, and this is not a job they will like. Okay, so this will be the main area where I will actually do stuff. Actually, let's gather the apples first of all, because if you gather the apples in the first day as soon as possible, they'll grow back in a day or two. So yeah, always gather the apples at maximum. And he'll have to construct that because we need another villager very, very fast. Okay, now the way I like to build my village is a little different from what most people will do. So their rooms will be 6x6. 5x5 is okay, but it's a little smaller if you think about it. It's a little too small. So it will be something like this. And now we just have to put their beds down. And I like the beds to be very close to each other so they can actually, you know, if something goes bad or something is really, really wrong, they can just go back to bed. And you need to be very efficient about your bed layout and other stuff. For example, this is Karin. I think she's our doctor, soldier and researcher. Yeah. And we'll get another colonist very, very soon, so she has to cut trees again. Now, to research, we actually need a finished room, so that means we kind of have to finish her room. Mm-hmm. And when the other guy comes along, he'll just have to gather more resources for us. Now, the game is very, very silly sometimes, so you'll have to ignore some problems, like, you know, you'll have to go to your boat. Well, this is something I don't really like. You have to search for the boat which brings the immigrants manually. Okay, where is that boat? Oh, here it is. Nah, it actually comes closer to. I thought it comes a lot further sometimes, okay? We'll send Bernard. Ah, we have... We'll have to send Karina because he still has an apple tree he didn't pick. Rotate the map. Even though the map seems a little simple, it's very hardcore, believe me. You'll also get a lot of events and you'll have a rough time surviving your first year. Okay, so now you have to pray it's a good character. Oh, it's a doctor, I don't need a... Well, it's tireless, so that's okay, because a tireless means it's a very, very hard worker. Let's gather all that cotton with him. Okay, so I have a few mods installed and the mods don't do much. I mean, only for Planned Parenthood, meaning I can choose when I want a child or a new colonist or dwarf or whatever you want to call them, and the UI improvements, which actually show what they are doing. Satisfaction points, current task and expectations. So we also need to work on that very fast. Okay, he's gathering the cotton because I don't really have, you know, a sleeping bed for him. And if they sleep on the floor, they'll lose a lot of HP and they might die, so don't do that. And we'll be sharing our little rooms with the cows, so that's a fun thing. Okay, are you finished to the cotton? So the tireless trait means she or he needs to sleep 2 times less. So double the sleeping speed. Well, that's a skill I need in real life. Sleep faster, as Arnold Schwarzenegger said. If you don't have enough free time, sleep faster. Yeah. And also the houses have roofs on them, so you don't have to... Oh, I don't have enough resources. Okay, so everyone is sleeping and you can actually see their stamina bar rising.
Yep.
As you can see...
Yep.
It's a little faster for this guy, but we need to improve his mood. Also, a very, very important thing to build in the beginning is the fruit basket, because this is where they'll actually eat. And if they don't have food, well, it's not going to be fun. If you don't build that very fast, they'll actually starve to death and faint, and then you have to feed them while they are unconscious, and that's kind of rough to do. Now you can cut the trees, and he can cut to the trees because no more apples are there for us. And well, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Let me think about this. Catherine can be the builder because everything you do in the game will actually improve the. You get experience points. Let's just say it like that. I'm also having a very hard time focusing because this is a very brutal game. So you can actually. Sure. The main thing for her will be that she will build. As you can see, she can't apply sprints even though she has a medic of level 2 because she needs to have that skill and no points are available. Yeah, I also need more Rudy and I'll have to give them tools. So this is the very rough part of the game where you're struggling to get things done. And this is the problem with having big rooms. You need a lot of resources to actually build them. So if you want to play the game and actually learn it in a more decent way, just build smaller rooms, 4x4 or stuff like that. And then you can just expand them when you want. No, Bernard, you'll have to gather the trees. Oh, we're out of food. Actually, we're running out of food, but that's not a problem. If you try to fight with the cows, they'll actually kick your ass, so don't do that. Actually, I never tried to tame a cow. Let's see what happens. Okay, such a good cow. They also, based on their moods, they'll have a better chance to, you know, work and don't stop working.
Yep.
Okay, let's see if we can tame Emily. Now, as I said, Katrina will be the farmer and the miner, so that will be kind of like a double thing. No, Karina. Bernard will be the farmer and the miner. Oh, okay. And he can also cook at the campfire. So before you do that, we just have to, you know, take the crystals, put them there, use them for research. And it's a very slow game, as you can see, and I'm... Remord is a lot more responsive because then you can actually plan much better, but in this game, planning never goes according to the plan. I'm curious if a cow will give us milk. I just want to try this out because we have the cows very, very close to us. Okay, good job, Bernard. I mean, it's better if you have someone that can research, because if she's not doctoring will be her main focus. And she doesn't have anything to fight. Yeah, it's good. This will be right next to her bed because, you know, reasons. All is work. Now we have to choose a research, and the research you want to do is farming, first of all. And now her job is actually a scholar, but the job of the scholar actually means... Okay, so let's just say it like this. So a scholar also has the specialization of mining crystals and performing research. So it doesn't really matter if he's a miner or not, he'll still gather the crystals. No food left? Well, that's bad. Can we find some extra apple trees around here? Is someone an overeater or something? No? It's just that we don't have enough apple trees. I think you need about 10 apple trees to feed your colony in the beginning. I don't want to go... Yeah, I have no choice. So if you run out of food, don't worry. You can just send someone to trade with the goblins. And you can get a lot of food because you have some medical supplies. Oh, so that's what happened. To tame a cow, you need to give it food. So the cow ate all my food. That's hilarious. So let's give them a healing potion for food. The strawberries are kind of expensive. No, no, no. Let's not do that. So let's see where another village is located. We also have kind of like maximum stockpile, so if you don't build storage spaces, you'll have to... You'll have a very limited storage supply. These guys are not selling food either. About these guys. I like the options. You have the option to destroy them. Fight. No fight. Well, I guess they really hate us. Sticky Goblin, so this is zero. The mysterious people of the moon. So you also have to be in good relations in order to trade with them. The village of happiness will attack us on sight. Warriors of the north, okay. Mm-hmm. Now, who was the person actually doing the trade? Okay, Bernard, go and trade with them.
Yeah.
Okay, I hope they will give us some food, because I didn't think about that. So the goblins near us are friend. What are you doing? He might die, that's the problem. Easy now, easy.
Mm-hmm.
Because he ran out of food.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll just have to see it. It will kind of be on the limit, and I hope we can make it, because he will start dropping health very soon. Those guys are sleeping, which is okay. Tomato. Oh, finally, we can buy some food. Even though we don't have a lot of stuff, we can just trade some crystals and all the wood available to us. 24 coins, and we'll just get the tomatoes. Okay, so we are officially out of food, so this guy will probably faint along the way, so let's make him come here. And let's check on the apple trees. 0.3 days, so okay, that will be enough.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
mm-hmm.
Yep.
And right now we're gathering food. Okay, Emily, oh, so don't try to tame the animals in the beginning. Yeah, I know we are having low spirits just because you don't have food, but things will be better, I promise, guys. Don't worry. Now, usually you get a better start, but this time I just want to try with the taming. And it's important to know to which goblins you can sell what. Well, eat something, you idiot. Also, sometimes check on their bed. So Bernard doesn't have a bed for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this is where things get a little complicated, and this is what I don't like about the game sometimes. You really have to check the ownership sometimes. This is not owned by anyone, so let's go over this again. So Karina is over there.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Bernard will be over here.
Yeah.
Oh man, I wish you could change their name or something, because this will get very confusing later. And their names are also kind of hard to remember. Okay, we have a little food right now, but we should be okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I don't just stand and look at the moon. Cut that tree, because you'll be quite close to the apple tree. Okay, on the limit. Huh. So I guess you survive for another day.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now the problem is, if you kind of lose track of what you are doing and with who you are doing it, it'll be kind of bad. Anyway, but that's just to show you your multiple... you can fail in a lot of ways, but you can also win in a lot of ways. So, who was my researcher again? Okay, you should analyze the crystals, because that's your main job. And that will unlock farming, yep. And then... we'll finally have something to do for Bernard, who is a master farmer. He's also quite tired. Also, they are slacking. You'll become a forester and you'll cut down the tree. So some of... this is what the main difference between this game and RimWorld is. They will slack off a lot of time, so you'll have to manually give them commands, manually check on them, manually look on what they're doing and so on. So I thought I had enough to tame the cow, but apparently it's kind of hard to do it, and the taming progress will drop down. So I guess you can only do this once you have a farm going on. Now, before you, if you don't have the farming research, you can't build anything, see? And this is kind of like a tight spot for my farming space. Usually I like to farm near my house, but I guess I can do it like this. So Bernard is there and he'll be my master farmer. Okay, research was completed, the next will be woodworking and Bernard. You come here and it's time to build the crops. Now, the tomatoes will actually be only available for a very, very short period. Because it's so late. So don't build a lot of them, just build a few of them. Three, four, five, six, seven. So let's do only a few of them. By the way, you have to be so meticulous about it. If you want them to look good, you have to be very specific. See, like this. And actually, let's have a few more, because I want to be sure he will be able to gather everything and we also have enough. This is kind of like the maximum of you can make anyway, so let's go and construct that. Catherine, help him. It will take a while before the food grows, but we have maximum wood. Because that's the maximum storage we have right now, so... let's see what they want for now. I don't want them to have a fit and stop working. Okay, they are decent, so they don't need much, so let's build a wood stockpile for now. No, you have enough time to construct this. Stop being lazy, guys. Now, it's better that you keep all your little minions on the same sleep schedule. It's fine, don't worry. So as you can see, she's a researcher, and the other will be friends with them. So they'll ask items from your inventory. They will not ask things you don't have, so that's good, but at the same time, it's bad. Okay, so she will start constructing, and Bernard can start to be a farmer. And he'll remain a farmer for the rest of the game, if we survive for the rest of the game. Now, she'll go to sleep. They can usually take care of themselves pretty good. What, you're hungry? I said plant the tomato, stop wasting time. You have to fight with them sometimes. Okay, it will be a very long time before I finish the houses, but most of their expectations mean that they have to have a house and a room. Oh, I forgot to show you the roof. This is the roof. Ta-da! Bernard. Oh, Well, there is no other way around it. He wants a bedroom, so we'll have to give him a bedroom. And that prevents him from collapsing. So we will not have a mental break. Oh, come on, just sow the tomatoes, you idiot. You. Sometimes they want to have their full meters, otherwise they'll not do anything, which is kind of bad for me. Where is Karina going and what's she doing? Well, thank you for reminding me of that apple tree. Now get back to work. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. So you need to, even though she's not a miner, she needs to know what crystals to mine.
Yep.
Also, we need a loom for her, otherwise she'll start to get really depressed. Huh. Things are not really going my way for now, but they never do. A bug infestation is very, very bad for your colony. Yep. It can kill your entire crop, so just remove all the infected plants. Okay, things are... Stop doing that, gather the crystals. Huh. I wonder why the little dwarf was doing this. She didn't have that thing over there. And it will take a lot of work for this crop to grow. So again, this is the season. Some crops are seasonal, so you have to make them in the same season and also harvest in the same season. Actually, if it's not winter, they might grow and you can harvest them later. But if winter comes, all your crops die. Okay, when I have 5 crystals, I'll just send her to research. Well, trading is great, but... I don't really have anything to trade, so no. And now we are just waiting for everything to be okay. Also, sometimes I'll just make some items in the rooms so they are not angry with me. So build that so your mood goes a little better. Okay, so now she will not stop working. If they stop working and they have a bad mood, well, that can be a disaster because they'll also prevent the other workers. The other guys from doing work.
Yep.
We might need to trade.
Yep.
Oh, I hate it when they are on such a off-key sleeping schedule. So let me see, what's your cheapest food item? The tomatoes, of course. Bread is good, but... it's kind of expensive, so let's see. The healing potions are very expensive and you have a few of them, so... let's just sell all of that and buy... What else do I need? I don't want to buy the expensive food. By the way, the goblins can ask for a potion, so that's why I usually don't give them away to the goblins. But thinking about it, I think it will be a little better if I buy something so I don't have them in my inventory. Wooden watering can... Oh, actually, that's pretty good. I want one. We'll also be gaining 23 coins, which I don't have enough storage to, because you need a safe to store the coins. Now, let's see, what else can I buy that is pretty cheap and I actually can use it? Strawberries. delicious strawberries, I'm tempted, but I guess I don't have enough storage. Yeah, I know. Okay, let's just have it like that. And we'll actually build something for him, the storage for a tool. Once he's done with woodworking, so he can actually be better at his job. And we also need to unlock the water. It's a very complicated game. We need the watering technology for the well. I think he can get water from the ocean, but I don't know if that will work. Now, if he does growth progress, possible yield one tomato, nothing is watered. It's very hard to get food without the technology in the beginning.
Yep.
Also, I need to make them happy because I want one more colonist before the season ends.
Mm-hmm.
A chair will not come to us very soon.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But I guess I can build him a storage for the medicine. Yeah, actually need to check out the trader a lot more in the beginning because he seems to be very helpful. 45 wood, okay. You can't really get a lot of work done in the beginning if you just, you know, sit around and wait. So let's just build a couple of more things and watch their progress and then I'll end the video after we finish researching the woodworking. Bernard, stop doing anything else. Just tend to the crops. And here, this will make you happy. Okay, woodworking was unlocked, and then I just want gardening so I can get to the watering part. The other stuff is very important as well, but again, I just want to be sure I will not have any food problems.
Mm-hmm.
Are you limping? When did you hurt your leg? I was not even watching. So Karina can actually splint the legs, so he'll be much better. This is why you need a doctor.
Yeah.
Okay, silly.
Yeah.
Oh, it actually worked from a distance. Sometimes you have to check their health.
Yeah.
Just in case, you know. And then we'll actually have to build the work table, the workshop for the tools. And the researcher will be also the builder, and the researcher will have many, many things to do in the beginning. No, I'll not have enough, I'll not have more time to plant more tomatoes, so that's enough. We'll have to switch to potatoes pretty soon. So potato mode incoming. Oh, when? What? Did I miss these apple trees? I didn't see them before. I guess I was blind or something. I'll have to go back to the video and check it, because I think, yeah. So he's a farmer, so one of the things he has to do is harvest the apple trees. So let's just put that under his official duty, because he built... Oh, he has a... whatever. He still has a few things to plant.
Mm-hmm.
Stop doing that. Do your job. I don't know. Sometimes they do random stuff because it's not in their main objective. So, forest will be the final thing you do. Okay, so that's much better. And now let's build the tools. I want them to be perfect, but it's never perfect. You really want to build it in somewhere you can see it very fast, because you'll give a lot of orders to them to build it. Hey, wait, where are you going? And yeah, the first tool will have to be a wooden sword. I don't have that technology. A wooden sword? Why a wooden sword? It will be a wooden axe, and then a wooden pickaxe probably, and then maybe some swords and stuff along the way, but... Trust me, this is a very fun game to play if you actually learn the basics of it. And I'll actually play off camera for a little while. See you next time. Bye.